Thanks very much, Ali. Ali's been a terrific partner of ours and a great advocate for the FedStart program. I'm Mark Brunner, and I work at Primer Technologies. Primer's mission is to equip and empower those who protect our country and our democracy. And our tools enable the U.S. government, strategic allies, and our commercial partners to extract timely insight and decision advantage from massive data sets. That's our why. But today I'd like to talk about our how. And we're extraordinarily confident in our product and our record of work, whether that's with the soft community, intelligence analysts, or others. We've got cutting-edge AI research and nimble architecture. We're confident in the future we're creating. And because we're smaller, we're agile enough to bring cutting-edge, reliable AI to these partners. But because we're small, we also face certain limitations in how we could bring our talent, our technology, and our team to work with the U.S. government. These include onerous compliance costs, lengthy bureaucratic delays, and also opportunity costs when we think about where we invest our capital. And most in this room know that it often takes 12 to 24 months for a company to get certified to offer its software for the national security mission. Major hurdles include FedRAMP, authority to operate on government networks, and also facilities clearances. And these are all adjudicated by different government agencies. There is no one-stop shop with the U.S. government, unfortunately. And all of these certifications require an investment of $2 to $4 million for each certification. But the good news is many of these challenges are no longer an obstacle for Primer. Because everything changed after a conversation we had with Palantir in May. We were introduced to FedStart. Palantir's FedStart program gave us that one-stop shop and an economically viable platform to FedRAMP High. And look, this is a game-changer initiative for a company like ours. And it's also a way that Palantir is building a coalition by allowing small companies like ours to work and compete for national security business with larger primes like Palantir. Let me offer you an analogy. My background is I'm a former naval aviator. And almost through the entirety of my career, I've worked in a coalition environment. And in those environments, you have US military personnel operating alongside the forces of other countries. Some are big, the US obviously, the UK, France, Germany, and some are small, it could be New Zealand. But I'll tell you what, when you're flying a mission in a coalition environment, you don't talk about GDP, you're not considering population size of your partners. What you're looking for is what each unit has to contribute, and you're working to leverage that contribution to the greatest possible advantage. And of course, big countries can do more, but everyone can bring something to the table. And in coalition warfare, you need to do this because you have a common mission and a common challenge. And for us in the defense enterprise today, for us in the innovation community, that holds true also, because everyone has something to contribute, big and small. And again, we have this common mission that we're all pursuing, which is to give the national security community the tools they need to protect our country and our democracy. And these challenges I talked about earlier, which include the compliance costs, the bureaucratic delays, the lengthy system, and then also the opportunity costs for our capital. And Palantir is bringing this coalition mentality to the defense enterprise, and through FedStart, it's possible to bring more and varied companies to the fight. And this gives us the ability to architect our offerings just like a coalition battle plan. It's resourcing, it's planning, and it's execution. And it's extraordinarily gracious. It's extraordinarily impactful for our national security mission, and it lets smaller innovators like Primer complement larger primes like Palantir. And again, by working together, we can achieve a force that's greater than its individual parts. Now, let me highlight how our AI-powered solution at Primer, what we call Primer Delta, is contributing to this shared mission of bringing agility and reliability to the DoD.
Our analyst, Natasha, has been assigned to start tracking the deteriorating situation in Mali. She is new to the team, and her previous assignment on Kyiv has given her little familiarity. She explores a new project. Reading through the comments, she sees a link to a timeline. Scrolling through the timeline, she sees a name, Asimi Goata. It appears several times, and she is unfamiliar. Curiosity drives her to dive deeper. She clicks on his name. She notices that Asimi is more strongly connected to the Wagner group than expected. Clicking on the group's entity, she decides to view the documents that form the connection. Reading through the content, she is alarmed to learn of a strong connection between the two and decides this needs to be monitored. She saves the document to the project and instructs Primer Delta to track this interaction. Using the search bar, she types, "Let me know if there are any Wagner troop movements out of Belarus involving Mali." Delta responds, and Natasha decides to get more people involved. Returning back to the project home, she tags a colleague in her comment on the newly added document. With Primer Delta, Natasha quickly connects with her colleague to complete the knowledge loop and helps her team maintain overall situational awareness. Natasha returns to the home screen to continue with her work when magically, an alert comes in. As soon as new data is collected, the system realizes this connection and immediately alerts Natasha. Powerful all before lunch. That's Primer Delta.
Many of you may be familiar with JADC2, which is the Pentagon's initiative to connect all of our battle networks and have integrated communications and data transfer, right? And so as we think about that JADC2 loop, which is sense, make sense, decide, and act, Primer is the make sense part of that link. And what we do is we shorten the information loop between the sensor and shooter, we reduce the latency, and we ingest large amounts of data immediately from a sensor platform, digest it rapidly using our natural language processing capabilities, and then transmit it back to the intelligence and operators in the battlefield so we can get as close to real-time situational awareness for our warfighters. And again, with Primer, the human being remains in the loop because we're not looking to replace the human in the loop. We're simply looking to provide the human better information to make a decision. Let me close with one last thought on the coalition mindset that we just discussed and its value on the home front. When you're operating in a coalition environment, there are times when you're trusting another someone from someplace else with your life, and they're doing the same for you. And trust has to be at the core of that relationship. No coalition works without it. And that's true for us in this room today. And speaking for Primer, we first decided to explore the program because of a single conversation we had in May with Palantir's Aki Jain. And after our discussion was over, we felt the right level of trust was there, and we moved forward. And the defense enterprise benefits. Like I said before, it's gracious of Palantir, and it's impactful. Thank you for your time this afternoon.